What's up, everybody? Welcome back to What's New in EDU Live. I'm Tony Jackson, a fourth grade teacher from Hackensack, New Jersey, and I'm going to be giving you the scoop on new products and features live from here at ISTE.
Sorry, Tony Jackson?
Yes, sir.
Take a selfie.
Let's go.
Awesome. Thank you.
Absolutely. So these past few days have really flown by, and my kids are going to flip when they see all that I've learned. You get Flipgrid, you get... Okay, anyway, we've been learning so much all week, and we've only scratched the surface. Okay, we're going to kick it off now, so let's go to Shindy.
Thanks, Tony. I'm Shindy, and this is Javier, and we both work for the Windows Education Devices team. We couldn't be more delighted to be here to tell you about the Windows 10 in S mode. We have devices that start at $189, and we have touch and ink devices starting at $279. When we talk to schools like Marshall Public Schools in Marshall, Minnesota, they tell us the importance of being able to deliver a cloud-based experience, the importance of security, and that these devices are totally rugged. Do you know how hard middle schoolers can be on their devices? We'll show you. For instance, are you serious? It's spill-proof? I didn't even know that. Oh my goodness. Wow, but how about when they pack them in their backpacks and then just happen to come home from school and... No! Drop them? Outrageous! Is this thing still gonna work out here?
Indeed it is.
All right, thanks, Tony.
Hey folks, I've been documenting my time here at ISTE, and we're gonna do something awesome with the footage. Melinda here is gonna show you how to make that happen while I grab some more shots.
Thanks, Tony. So the Photos app includes a built-in video editor, which makes it super easy for students to create narratives, project reflections, take the place of a traditional lab report, anything they're looking to do to in a familiar medium. So Tony captured a bunch of photos and video clips as he's been out on the floor, and I'm helping him make this video that'll include some of his spoken word. So we can drag these down to the storyboard to construct that narrative and resize to remove those black bars and zoom in on him in the action. One of the big things that we heard from educators was that students wanted to be able to have both music and narration. And so we've added the ability to add narration. We'll import the audio that Tony recorded earlier, his ISTE reflections, and add that to our project. And you can see that it comes in along our timeline, and we can slide it anywhere we want to get it lined up with the action, or even go ahead and trim it if students have a couple ums and ahs that they want to cut off. We'll say done and see how that sounds. Sounds like our music is overpowering Tony's spoken word, so we'll go in and adjust the levels here. We can turn the music down here in our volume mixer to a little more reasonable level. Once you've got your project complete, coming for back to school is the ability to add that project to the cloud so that they can work on their video projects on their PC at school or back at home. Let's see how we did.
This atmosphere is electric. What happens here is the methods for teaching meet the resources we need, and the teachers have poured in to find them. In workshops, sessions, keynotes, we hope help us take each element and combine them.
Thanks, Melinda. What an engaging way to learn. And speaking of engagement, I hear there's some really exciting things happening in this futuristic world we're living in. Mike, what can you tell us?
Thanks, Tony. This is Mike Dolphson from Microsoft Education here at ISTE, and we're in the Windows Mixed Reality portion of our booth. So big announcement today. The Limitless Libraries Grant was started to enrich the learning experience at public schools and libraries. We believe with digital technology like mixed reality headsets, we can engage students, help with retention, and improve learning outcomes. Now, this grant is open for the first-time recipients, and they're going to be selected at the end of this summer. The recipients get Windows mixed reality headsets, they get a computer, and they get staff and administration training and PD. So this first grant will be available for 6th through 12th grades as well as libraries, and you can sign up today at aka.ms/limitless-libraries. Now, as a bonus, we've just announced we've got the immersive reader right here as a prototype in the mixed reality headset. So why immersive reader in VR? So think about those kids that you might pull out for 20 minutes, the reading specialists or librarians, to really give them a little bit of extra focus. So now with the immersive reader fully embedded in VR, it's quite a powerful experience that we believe can help improve student outcomes. We're going to be prototyping more this summer, and into the fall. So we really would love your feedback. So thanks, Tony.
That's great. Thanks, Mike. Now, there has been a lot to be excited about here at ISTE, but my biggest takeaway so far has been the energy of the educators and their excitement about using all of this connectivity to genuinely connect with their students and to help their students connect globally in order to put all of this learning into action. Now, if you didn't see the previous live episode, there's a link in the description below, so check that out as well. But stick with me, we have one more day here at ISTE. Make sure to tune in live on Facebook at 5 p.m. Central Time. That's all we have for you now, so go learn something new. Peace.
See you next time!